हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री पार्ट 3। इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस इज द प्रोसेस व्हिच इन्वॉल्व्स कन्वर्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इनटू केमिकल एनर्जी। वी कैन से दैट प्रोसेस व्हिच लीड टू केमिकल चेंज और डिकम्पोजिशन ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट व्हेन एन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज पास थ्रू either its aqueous solution or molten state. During electrolysis, both oxidation and reduction take place in the same cell. Anode carry positively charge and cathode carry negatively charge. During this process, cations migrate towards cathode and anions migrate towards anode. If there are two or more ions compete at the one electrode, ion with higher reduction potential gets liberated at the cathode, while the ion with lower reduction potential at the anode. During electrolysis, voltage required is the same as standard electrode potential, but during liberation of gases, we need sometimes extra voltage. This extra voltage required is called over voltage or bubble voltage. How can we predict product of electrolysis if there is more than one ion reach at one electrode? For example, if sodium and hydrogen both reach at the cathode, then which one will be liberated? If the cation has a higher reduction potential than water, for example, minus 0.83 volt, cation is liberated at the cathode. Neither hydrogen gas is liberated. For example, during electrolysis of copper or silver, copper and silver collected at the cathode, but during electrolysis of sodium chloride, hydrogen gas collected at the cathode. Similarly, if anion has a higher oxidation potential than water, anion is liberated. Otherwise, oxygen gas produced at the anode. Discharge potential. It is a minimum potential that must be applied across the electrode to bring about the electrolysis and subsequent discharge of ion on the electrode. Faraday law of electrolysis, first law, amount of the substance liberated at the cathode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity passed. Q is the charge, W is the amount of substance. W is directly proportional to Q. Or we can say W is directly proportional to product of I and T. I is the current passed in during the process, and T is the time. Remove the proportionality, we can write W is equal to I T Z. Z is the electrochemical equivalent. It is a constant. If we take 1 ampere current is passed, I is equal to 1 ampere, pass for 1 second only, then Q is equal to 1 coulomb. We can say W is equal to Z, means electrochemical equivalent is the amount of the substance deposited when 1 ampere current is passed for a 1 second. Second law of the Faraday, when the same quantity of electricity is passed through different electrolytes, amount of the substance deposited or liberated at the electrode are directly proportional to their equivalent weight. Mass of the A divided by mass of B is equal to equivalent weight of A divided by equivalent weight of B. Or we can say electrochemical equivalent is directly proportional to equivalent weight. Batteries, which we need daily in our life, it is a good source of electrical energy, and which may be one or more cells connected in series. For a good quality of battery, we need it is compact, its voltage should not vary appreciably, and it should be light in weight. Batteries are of two types, primary batteries and secondary batteries. Primary batteries, which cannot be reversed back, the action occurs only once. We can say after use over a period of time, battery becomes dead and it cannot be reused again. Dry cell or Leclerc cell. It is an example of primary cell. In this, anode made up of zinc and cathode made up of graphite rods surrounded by manganese dioxide powder. Electrolyte use ammonium paste of ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. During this process, at the anode, Zn converted into the Zn2 positive ion after lose two electrons. These two electrons reach at a cathode where manganese dioxide carry Mn4 positive charge converted into that of Mn3 positive ion. In this case, MnOOH and release of ammonia gas. This ammonia gas combined with their zinc ion form a complex, and the complex of zinc ion by ammonia molecule decreases the concentration of zinc 2 positive ion and increases the voltage of cell. Cell potential remains 1.25 volt to 1.5 volt. But it is not a long life because zinc chloride paste in a dry cell is acidic in nature and corrodes the zinc container even when not in use. Cell is another example of primary cell. Anode made up of zinc mercury amalgam and cathode is based off HGO and carbon. Electrolyte used moist base of KOH and ZnO. First of all, at anode, zinc amalgam combined with electrolyte OH negative ion to convert into ZnO and release electrons. These electrons reach at a cathode where HGO combined with the electron to convert into Hg. During this process, there is no ion involved. Overall reaction when will be right, there is no ion involved. So that there is no change in concentration take place, therefore potential of the cell remain constant not only during its operation but throughout its life. And cell cross potential remain constant, that is 1.35 volt. Secondary batteries, which can be reused again and again, which can be recharged. There are two examples, lead storage battery and nickel cadmium storage cell. Storage battery, anode made up of spongy lead, cathode made up of grid of lead, packed with red brown lead dioxide. Electrolyte used sulfuric acid 38% by mass, having density 1.3 gram per ml. At anode, lead combined with electrolyte sulfate ion to form lead sulfate PbSO4 and release electron. These electrons reach at a cathode where red lead dioxide PbO2 combined with electrolyte SO42 negative ion H positive ion to form their lead sulfate. Overall reaction Pb plus PbO2 plus 4H positive plus 2SO42 negative gives PbSO4 plus H2O. When we recharge the cell reaction will be reverse. At anode during the recharging, PbSO4 gained 2 electrons to convert into Pb plus SO4 to negative. And at the cathode, PbSO4 combine with water to form their PbO2 plus SO4 negative plus 4H positive plus 2 electron. Fuel cell. The cell which convert chemical energy of a fuel directly into electrical energy. For example, hydrogen, CH4 methane, methanol. Fuel cell are pollution free and have a high efficiency. Example of fuel cell, hydrogen oxygen fuel cell, electrodes made up of porous graphite impregnated with catalyst, platinum, silver or a metal oxide. Electrolyte use aqueous solution of potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide. In this, oxygen and hydrogen are continuously fed into the cell at anode. Hydrogen combined with electrolyte OH negative ion to convert into water and release electron. These electrons reach at a cathode where oxygen combined with electron O2 plus 2H2O plus 4 electron gives us 4OH negative. Overall reaction is H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O. Corrosion, it is a slow process. During this process, deterioration of metal takes place or undesirable compounds such as oxide, sulfide or carbonate at the surface of metal by reaction with moisture and other atmospheric gases. Factors by which corrosion increases due to reactivity of metal. Highly reactive metal corrode easily. Presence of moisture and atmosphere gases also increases corrosion on a metal. Presence of impurities, strain in a metal. Presence of electrolyte. Rusting of iron is an electrochemical theory. In this, anode is made up of pure iron and cathode is an impure surface. Any iron rod, it comes in contact with the atmosphere, carbon dioxide, water. There is a formation of their carbonic acid H2CO3. At anode, iron loses their electron to convert into Fe2 positive ion. From an electrolyte H positive ion, an electron we will be get from the anode, it reaches at the cathodic area where oxygen combined with electrolyte H positive ion to convert into water. Overall reaction, iron reduced to the Fe2 positive ion, or we can say at a surface Fe2 positive ion plus oxygen plus water gives that of ferric oxide Fe2O3. This ferric oxide combined with water molecule, X water molecule to form their Fe2O3.XH2O. A brown layer formed at the iron or the rusting take place. Rusting of iron can be prevented by following method. First, barrier protection by coating of paints or electroplating with a highly reactive metal. Through galvanization or coating of surface with tin metal. Galvanization is the coating of the zinc by the use of anti-rust solution by cathodic protection in which metal is protected from the corrosion by connecting with another metal that can easily oxidize.